When Jamin talked to me attending this meeting, I was wondering why am I here, because I am not expert in supply chain and logistics. We have got expert like Parab, who has been there over the years. I've been in the healthcare industry and more have been selling the products. So Prabhat and all of us were talking about that we have been from those kind of days where one used to sell the products. But nevertheless, Jamin said that you need to talk about the industry and you need to also talk about the impact of coming elections, what will happen. So that was the brief which he gave. So I said to him that I'm not a political expert. So I would like to look back at some of the hypotheses which I have, and I've got strong faith in this market. I've been part of the healthcare industry for now 40 years. And when I joined the industry, it was at a very infancy stage. We didn't have voice on the table. But certainly I can say now in any international forum, Uday and me were part of CPHI at Madrid recently, and we can certainly say that India occupies a place of pride as far as the global industry is concerned. And two industries, two sectors of the economy which has given pride to India is pharma industry and technology industry. And if both of the industries start combining together, that will be the magic, and that will be the magic which will be happening. I will say that the Indian pharma industry growth now will be supply-led growth instead of demand-led growth. And I will work on that hypothesis that supply chain side disruption will make big difference as far as the Indian market is concerned. So the way my structure will go is, first I will talk of the market, overview of this market. Then I will talk of key future growth drivers and how do I see market going forward. There will be some facts which are there, which many of you may know, but it will be good to look at the facts the way they are. The market in India, recent December 19 figures have come in, IMS, it is around $19 billion market at this particular moment. And as Udayji was saying, that export market this year will be around $19 billion. So it's a $38 billion market, quite a sizable market. As far as domestic industry is concerned, we have got a growth of around 9 to 10%, and the market which went down to 6% has revived again. And the way we look at the market, and I'm very confident that this market will continue to get around 10 to 11% growth as far as domestic market is concerned. Export market, Uday talked about it, but domestic growth will be around 10 to 11%, and in next 5 years, it should be around 200,000 crore market. So we expect that it should be around $29 to $30 billion market by 2022. The facts are very clear. It is third largest in terms of volume, 13th largest in terms of value, but we have got 1.7% share of the global market compared to the population of around 16%. It's a highly under-leveraged market, very low penetration of the market, and only 40% of the population in India get the benefit of healthcare. So whatever happens, there is a tremendous underlying demand in this market. So Indian market will continue to grow with double-digit growth. And the way I look at it, at this market, it will be primarily volume-led growth market, primarily building the infrastructure of this market, and the distribution and doctor infrastructure will play a very important role. And if we start getting the combination of technology, which will improve the access of healthcare, where a lot will be happening, the growth of the market will continue to grow very high. If we look at which Udayji is expert, we have got around 600 US approved plant. As far as this market is concerned, we are largest exporter of generic drug. I was part of the RP conference here, American Association of Physicians of India, and it was feeling so proud that every third tablet in US is sold from India, and every sixth patient in US is seen by Indian doctor, Indian origin doctor. So the whole healthcare industry is being handled by India. So it was so proud to know we have got 100,000 doctors today in the US who handle healthcare system. So the whole healthcare, we may have this transition problem, but if we also see the notification which has come, warning notification, as far as Indian industry is concerned, they are much lesser compared to even US and Chinese industry. It's a common kind of thing. So it is a passing phenomena. So we have made a tremendous way as far as the global market is concerned. If you see, again, sorry, there is some. If you see volume and new product, this is very, very important. The market used to grow around 16.7% earlier days, and the primarily the growth drivers of the market were new products as well as pricing. But if you see over a period of time, new product contribution has come down from 6.9 to 4%, and pricing virtually is static this year, 0.9%. It's virtually static. And the growth which has come back now is the volume growth of the market. So one of the great hypotheses which I have is it is the volumes and volumes and volumes which will contribute to the growth of the market, because underlying there's a tremendous demand. So the companies which are focused on the volume growth, we will see the reduction in the new product introduction launch. The days are over of FDC being introduced. The days are over of local FDA registration. So what we'll see is primarily volume growth as far as the market is concerned. The great advantage India has compared to most of the other markets of the world is we have got dual burden of disease. People say that is there any opportunity in the both the segments? I continue to hold the view that there is an opportunity both in acute and chronic care of the market. 65% is at the moment is acute care, 35% is chronic care. Both the segments will grow. Chronic care, all of us know, India is the diabetes capital of the world. Hypertension cases are increasing. Mental diseases, which has not started exploding. I see a lot of opportunity going forward as far as mental disease market is concerned. So there is an opportunity in chronic care, and there is also tremendous opportunity of penetration as far as acute care, anti-infectives, those markets are concerned. And I will build on this hypothesis going forward. As far as companies are concerned, there is going to be big consolidation, although the valuations are still quite high. But more and more when the regulatory structure in India, 40 companies which are having turnover of more than 500 crores, rest of them, they are having less than 500 crores. So out of 10,000 companies, only 40 companies, I'm talking of domestic market, have turnover less than, more than 500 crores. They will find it economically unviable. They will find it that it is not justifiable to have those kind of standards. So likelihood of a lot of consultation taking place. 100 company has got 100 crores turnover. So beyond 100 companies, there are 10,000 companies. So we will see a lot of churning in next 5 years taking place. I don't see any big movement in terms of policy shape, policy change in next 6 months till election. But after election, whether it is quality control, whether it is promotion practice, I will talk about it, start happening. And next 5 years, I see churning taking place, which will benefit both supply side of the organization as well as pharma side of the operation. The market is highly fragmented. Although we see here top 10 companies accounting for 43% compared to, say, US market, but we have got a long tail afterwards. So we will see a lot of consolidation taking place. Secondly, we will see a lot of consolidation taking place in the distribution front. Top 10 companies account for only top 10 distributors, account for only 7% compared to, in the US case, around 95%. And we have got a lot of supply chain experts here. And there is a big amount of inefficiency at every stage of supply chain, whether it is transportation, whether it is storage, whether it is retail chain, whether the way the person buys the medicine, there is inefficiency. And I see total transformation taking place in next decade as far as this part of the whole situation is concerned. So there is a retailer fragmentation as far as this part is concerned. There is distribution fragmentation. I remember very clearly, because I've been part of diabetes care insulin distribution in this country. I remember 25 years back, in every part of the country, the retailer will switch off the refrigerator before going on, because he says he will save the cost. But he didn't understand at that time that during the night time also insulin have to be stored in refrigerator. And Parab has been part of that distribution chain. Some of us in Novo Nordisk, Sanofi, Eli Lilly, we did a lot of work just to educate a retailer that you have to keep on the refrigerator in the night, and now we have come in. Still, we are way behind, so there is lot which has to take place as far as the whole chain. The key challenges, 40% of the people, and that's the key opportunities, 40% of the people get the benefit of healthcare, 60% have to travel distance to get the medicine and advantage of medicine. Most of the deliveries in the rural places take place at home. These are the facts. We have got 1.7 doctors and nurses compared to global standard of 2.5. And if I see doctors, we have got only 800,000 doctors compared to what is required, around 2 million doctors in this country. Huge demand. And can we produce the doctors in this country overnight? No. But if the digital technology, and that's why I keep on saying that combination of technology as well as medical science will make fundamental difference going forward. Government expenditure at this particular moment is the lowest in the world, 1%. And that too, compared to overall 4%, 75% is private sector and 1% with government. Now, over a period of time, there will be movement forward in this area, which will lead to the growth of this market. The market is at the inflection point. Regulatory environment, many of you may like to know the status of regulatory environment. One of the first things which around 1.5 years back, all of us in the pharma industry were very worried about the future direction of the industry. And first thing was generic, whether the prescription of generic will come, and Uday Bhaskar Saab must be aware at that particular moment, Mr. Modi announced in Surat that there will be generic prescription which will be there. But over a period of time, the government realized that the quality control standards are not so high that you allow generic manufacturer and allow the power to be shifted to the retail level. We don't have Jan Aushadhi store. We have got only 3,000 Jan Aushadhi store. The infrastructure does not allow generic prescribing. And as such, Indian market is a branded generic market. It is unlike other parts of the world. Only 5% of the products are patented products. Rest is branded generic. And the price of branded generic itself is so low, why we want to make it further generic. So at a policy level, many of us who have been part of many of the policy level committee, we are trying to work it out that generic is not the answer. And at this particular moment, we don't think generic going, although they may be allowed only in the medical colleges and institution, but we continue to see as far as branded generic market is concerned. Then government came out with national pharmaceutical policy. They said long licensing will not be allowed. One company can have only one brand. Also, that is under shelf at this particular moment. And Niti Aayog has recommended that that will not work. So according to our prognosis, that will not happen. Uniform code of marketing practices. Both Indian companies as well as multinational companies, they are aligned that uniform code of marketing practices will come, should come in. And if that happens, there is likelihood of further consultation. Because what happens in the country today, everyone thinks he can start pharma industry, and that's why 10,000 companies in this country. Everyone thinks that he can manufacture pharmaceutical product. But over a period of time, that will change, and uniform code of marketing practices is likely to come in 2019. Trade margin, capping of trade margin, that's a big thing. If it happens, it will help the industry. I've been part of stands where trade margin used to be high. It benefits the industry. So the industry is aligned, as far as OPPI is concerned, is aligned that there should be capping on the trade margin, which will get to the right kind of practice. The last part is the pricing. Government has set up a committee on pricing, and they are supposed to come with a policy towards the end of the year. We don't see any changes in first 6 months. There are two concepts. One is the cost-based price and market-based price. If it continues at cost-based price, it won't have much impact, and likelihood is it will continue, although they may broaden the scope of price control, but so long if it is market-based price, it will be healthy to the industry. The point is, Indian pricing as such is lowest in the world. So further impact on the pricing, and there is a lot of work which is being done by various association, and we are trying to say that the further price control will not make the difference. What we need to do is further improvement in quality and focus on R&D. Because if we have too much price control, it will also not help Indian exports, because many of the countries in the world, they are talking of reference pricing at this particular moment. So if we continue with the pricing emphasis, but that is a critical point for the industry, how much price control. And maybe all the association and all those who are interested, we are talking that price control, enough is enough. We should not further go ahead as far as price. We have advantage India as far as the overall India is concerned. All of us know we are the largest, fastest growing economy, 7.5% at this particular moment. We'll continue to grow to 7.5 to 8%. And with the uplifting of the economy, with the uplifting of the income, the healthcare industry is going to benefit. We have moved away from the stage of roti, kapda, makan to the issue of shiksha, sehat, and sadak. Those will be the election issues. Healthcare will become important part. Education will become important part. And there is advantage India. So according to me, we are at an inflection point. What we need to do is get back to research. So there is strong demand. We have got aging population, demographic advantage is there, increasing awareness, and policy support is rightly has to be there. We in the industry have to work with the government that this is the industry which can provide advantage to India going forward. Summary is double-digit growth, chronic therapy will grow, volume will be the critical driver, and there is going to be, nutshell of the story is, there is going to be consultation both on the company side as well as supply chain side. And what will become important is brand building, shaping the market, and perhaps movement forward in the R&D side of the business. I don't see much in the basic R&D, but biosimilars will start getting some importance, and complex generic and incremental innovation will start getting some kind of importance. Five growth drivers as far as the industry is concerned. One is the consolidation, supply chain consolidation, market shaping, reach, and digital. Given the time, I will just focus on the 5 points very briefly. The wave of consolidation began with Sun, with Daiichi and Ranbaxy, which went to Sun and Ranbaxy. Abbott and Piramal, that was the big consolidation. And if you see top 10 companies, Abbott came in top 10 companies, and if you see top 10 companies today, Abbott is the only multinational which is there in the top 10 companies. But there are a lot of companies, first, second, third, 8%, 7%, 6%, rest are 3 to 4%. From 4th to 7th and 8th, they are near 3%. And I will see some of the companies making a move to become among top 5, because there are a lot of players which are 3, 3.5, 3.2. So companies like Torrent, Zydus Cadila, Alchem, they will make a move, and everyone will like to be among top 5. So, and the other part of the story is, among multinational, only Abbott is there among top 10. So there is likely to be consolidation. We are seeing the consolidation wave as far as nutrition market is concerned. In last 3 months, we saw Zydus Cadila buying Complan, Levers getting into nutrition. P&G and Merck merging together. So there will be a lot of activity which will take place in the pharmaceutical space, nutrition space, and OTC space. It is OTC game at the moment is suboptimal. I see a lot of consolidation taking place at that moment, because there is no player which is more than 1,000 crores in OTC space. So there is likely to be consolidation which is taking place, and that will be the order of the day. Second wave is, we have got a lot of specialists as far as pharma consultation is there. In fact, Prabhat is there and Dr. Sunny Sharma is there, and I've been involved in some way. This is the space which will see maximum transformation. And we have got maximum inefficiency as far as supply chain side is concerned. 19 billion market, margin to retailer 20%, margin to distributor 10%, C&F 4 to 5%, expiries, return goods, bonus scheme. It is around 40% maybe on the conservative side. According to me, there is 8 billion market in debt, and is the patient getting the service which he deserves? Is he getting the storage which he gets? Is he getting the products in the form which he deserves? A big area of disruption. We have seen it in the medical devices side because of the government forced measure. But according to me, this is the place, whether demand side, whether inventory management side, whether expiry side, whether storage side, whether channel margin side, serving the customer side, the patient is suffering maximum as far as this area is concerned. And I see a lot of transformation taking place. And there are a lot of people, you have got role at every place. There will be a lot happening as far as $8 billion. I was just trying to look at the money which is lying there. Only and there will be big players will be coming in. People are thinking in my consulting assignments at various companies, people are thinking in a big way as far as this space is concerned. Big way of shaping the markets. A classical example, one has been part of Thyronorm journey, rule of half. There is a pain point for patient every place. Although we are diabetes capital of the world, we have got 70 million diabetic patients in this country. But there are only 5 to 6 million who get the right kind of treatment. Either he's not prescribed the right kind of dosage or doesn't take it. We are part of Thyronorm journey over the years. We are playing a lot of role in setting up diagnostic clinics, making sure that blood sample goes up. But have we done a job? Where are we at this journey at this particular moment? I will say we have not done even 10 to 15% of the job. Big opportunity in shaping up the market. So the companies who are involved in diabetes space, hypertension space, mental space has to start. We will see, because patient funnel is very, very clear. In diabetes, we have done a study where we say at every stage there is a rule of half, there is a leakage which is taking place. And all people here sitting here, plus the marketeers sitting here, plus R&D people sitting here, it's a big, big challenge. Only 10% to 15% people get the right kind of treatment. Reach, we don't talk big as far as the healthcare industry is concerned. Biggest product is Mixtard, one has been part of it, 500, 600 crores, nothing. In terms of size of the market, it is nothing. There is a big, big opportunity. Mankind started from rural markets, smaller cities. Big has to happen here. As far as Augmentin has taken a big step. They have increased the size of the field force from 500 to 1200 people. Big step by GSK, as far as the whole game is concerned for Augmentin. So reach will become very important going forward. Sorry, can you put back? Next thing is Ayushman Bharat, although it will start at a Ayushman Bharat, two steps which people have not talked at the moment, 150,000 primary healthcare centers, which will change the dimension. It will take time to stabilize, but according to me, 150,000 primary healthcare centers, which the government is trying to set up, they are talking 3 years period, which will open up the demand at all levels. Second is the insurance, which the company is talking about, 50 crore people. My emphasis and thrust is on the first part, which will take, it's like Asian Paints, Mankind going in the rural places. So the health awareness, doctor infrastructure, that will make the last step. I think the biggest innovation takes place at the intersection of biology and technology. And that's the point which I will want to leave the thought with. India has got tremendous advantage in technology as well as pharmaceutical things. We in Apex have bought recently the company. Yesterday we announced Fractal Analytics. We say artificial intelligence and technology role in healthcare will be very important. We have got shortage of doctors. Can technology play an important role to improve access? If that happens, and if we start working on better supply chain and availability of medicine, these two factors will combine and will make access of healthcare better. Already, many experiments are being done at this particular moment. many of you must be knowing, Tata Memorial Hospital, cancer hospital, only one in the country. They've started many of the tertiary centers, and telemedicine is being used by the hospital. Narayan Hrudayalaya is doing a lot of work in this area. Artificial intelligence, there are many companies which are experimenting that can the initial prescription be written based on artificial intelligence. So a lot of work which happen, which will take care of routine testing being done at the primary care center instead of coming to the hospital. I was surprised. I was with All India Institute of Medical Science. There are 15,000 patients which are seen in OPD in All India Institute of Medical Science, which is ridiculous. How can they be seen there? So can we shift some of these at primary care center and use technology? And we will see big changes in taking place. Online pharmacy, again, will be important going forward. So I will conclude by saying, we are at the right stage as far as Indian pharma market is concerned. Double-digit growth, key drivers, consultation, both on the company side as well as distribution side, and technology will be the critical driver. I wish you all the very best for the proceedings of this meeting. It has been great to be here, there, and thank you for patient listening. Thank you.